Sabrina. Inspired me. I wanted to. He wanted his story to be told, and then I wanted to do something to create something to spread the word. And it's connected to my journey as well, because I've been homeless a couple of times. So I've been here. Yeah. Also, for this walk, I wanted us when we're here, like to kind of experience a sense of homelessness. But I guess this is more like a group. Family. Yeah, feel it that much, but it's still like street level, so it's something.
I said like this could also be made at night, as you mentioned,
true.
Night situations, and that you can be alone and you don't know where to sleep, and I think it could be even more immersive if it happens.
That's why it makes space. Develop it over like a duration of, yeah. Kind of just next to the overground railway. It's like a control room. And all his stuff was there, were there, like untouched. And I think he was deported. Yeah. He should be like 56, 57 years old now. He's still alive, but I don't know where he is. I haven't. Some of the stuff I managed to save. I created an installation at Gaffin, and the rest of it is there. And also, I think someone's living there now. So, he talks about this. I have the whole journal, he talks about everything there. I'm not sure, like, if you're here.
So, Andrei, thank you very much. As we mentioned earlier, this piece continues in an installation at gas station. So, thank you for now. You can put your props on the trolley and forget about them. And then Claire will take us from here.
Thank you, Andrei.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks. No problem.
Yeah, no, I saw you earlier.